In part 3 of our lesson on trigonometric functions of acute angles, we're going to determine which trig functions are increasing or decreasing. Now, to do that, we need to analyze this diagram here. We're going to have two angles in the picture, and theta 2 is clearly greater than theta 1, which is down here. They're both in quadrant 1, and each angle has the same radius. So the radius of angle 1 is equal to the radius of angle 2, and to simplify things, we're going to just call each radius r. So the radius of angle 1 is r, the radius of angle 2 is r, and those radii are equal to each other. Now, in order to explore whether the sine function is an increasing or decreasing function, we can start out by using the definitions of the trig functions. Now, to get at that, we can begin with the fact that we can see that for theta 2, the y value of theta 2 is clearly greater than the y value of theta 1. So we can start out by saying that we know for sure that y2 is bigger than y1. Now, we can divide both sides by the same positive number, and we would keep our inequality. So we're going to divide both sides by r, which we know is positive. R is the distance from the origin to each of the terminal points. So y2 divided by r will be greater than y1 divided by r. Now, using our trig definitions, we know that this is the sine of theta 2, and that's going to have to be greater than this, which by using the definitions is the sine of theta 1. So what we just discovered is that the bigger angle, which is theta 2, has the bigger trig function when that trig function is sine. So as theta gets bigger, the sine of theta gets bigger. So as the argument of the function gets bigger, the function gets bigger, and if you remember from your college algebra class, that means that the sine function is increasing. Next, let's take a look at cosine, and we can see for theta 1, here is its x value, x1, and for theta 2, here is its x value, x2, and clearly x2 is less than x1 because it's to the left of it. Once again, we can take the inequality and divide both sides by the same positive number. So we're going to divide both sides by r. So x2 divided by r is going to be less than x1 divided by r. And if we apply our trig definitions, x2 over r is cosine of theta 2, and that's going to be less than x1 over r, which is cosine of theta 1. So what we've discovered is, as theta gets bigger, the cosine gets smaller. And you can see as the angle rotates from theta 1 to theta 2, its x value decreases. And so because of that, we say that the cosine function is decreasing. Now, if we turn our attention to tangent, we know that tangent, by definition, involves both y and x. Now, we know that y2 is greater than y1, and we know that x2 is less than x1. Now, to get to tangent, we know we're going to have to take y2 and divide it by x2, and we're going to have to take y1 and divide it by x1, and we need to think about the inequality symbol now. So because x2 is smaller, when the denominator of a fraction gets smaller, the fraction itself gets bigger, and x1 is bigger than x2, so as the denominator gets bigger, the fraction will get smaller. So with the numerator y2 being bigger than the numerator over here, y1, that makes this fraction bigger. The denominator is smaller than the denominator over here. That also makes this fraction bigger. So the inequality symbol is going to stay the same. And we're going to get that tangent of theta 2 is greater than tangent of theta 1. So the bigger angle had the bigger tangent. So as theta gets bigger, tangent of theta gets bigger. And that tells us that the tangent function is increasing. Now, in this example, we have to fill in each with a greater than, less than, or equal sign. So in example A here, we have the sine of 14 degrees, and we're going to compare that to the sine of 25 degrees. Now, because 14 is the smaller angle and 25 is the larger angle, we know as theta gets bigger, sine of theta gets bigger. So that means the bigger the angle, the bigger the sine of the angle, which means sine of 25 is going to be bigger than sine of 14, or another way of saying that is that sine of 14 degrees will be less than the sine of 25 degrees, because sine of theta is an increasing function. Next, we have to compare cosine of 42 to cosine of 65. Now, we just learned a minute ago that as the angle gets bigger, the cosine gets smaller. So the bigger angle is going to have the smaller cosine, or another way of saying that is that the smaller angle will have the bigger cosine. So we have to put in a greater than here, and that's because cosine of theta is a decreasing function. Now in part C, we have tangent of 27 degrees and cotangent of 66 degrees. Now we have a problem here because we have two different trig functions and we didn't do any analysis for cotangent. But now, this is a good chance to review your cofunction identities because we know that cotangent of 66 degrees is the same thing as the tangent of 90 minus 66 degrees, which would be the tangent of 24 degrees. And we've learned that the tangent function is an increasing function. So the bigger the angle, the bigger the tangent. So tangent of 27 is going to be greater than tangent of 24 because 27 is bigger than 24. And tangent theta is an increasing function. To help you better understand increasing and decreasing functions, let's take a look at this diagram. You can see that as the angle increases, the y value increases, so that means the sine function is increasing. But as the angle increases, the x value decreases, so that means the cosine function is decreasing.